How much does that outfit cost?
I'm not telling you. Next question.
Can you tell me something embarrassing?
Tell you something embarrassing?
A story.
I shit myself on stage once.
Sweet.
Doing a number. Opryland USA, dressed in Pop Denise. Remember? She was there, dressed in white polyester, a onesie, and giving it all. I got music, I got rhythm, and I think I have to fart. I got my gal, who can ask for anything more? I got daisies in green pastures, all of a sudden I feel heat. I got my gal, who can ask for anything more? Old man trouble, it's going down my leg. And I'm kicking shit into the audience. I don't mind him, you won't find him round my door. And the woman in front's going, is it raining? Oh. I go backstage, my understudy is there. He put laxative in my water that morning as a joke. And he was dressed ready to go on. Yep. So I walked past him and I went, excuse me. It was horrible. But it's one of my proudest moments on stage. You know why? I did not stop singing.
The show must go on.
Yes. I've got 2 minutes left, so quick fire questions and then I'll sing you a song. Ready?
Good, I have one question then.
Go ahead.
Do you plan on doing another album? Because I love your music.
Thank you. Not at the moment. It might be in the future, so keep an eye out, okay? Yes.
Hi, my name is Nathan, and this is actually my first ever con that I've
been. Virgin! Love you!
But a lot of people ask you, I bet, a lot about Malcolm Merlyn. I kind of want to take the focus away from Malcolm and go to your son, Tommy.
Yeah.
One of the reasons why I liked Deathstroke as a villain so much on Arrow was because he was Oliver's friend turned enemy, and then I guess kind of friend in the end. I know Tommy's dead, but if Tommy were to come back as a villain, maybe as Dark Archer 2, what are your thoughts on that?
That's up to them again. I don't have a problem with that. However, if you read the comic book that we wrote, the back history of Malcolm, he has another son also.
Really?
Yes.
I did not get to read that.
He has two sons. There's Tommy and then Saracen, who's his other son. And Saracen is more evil than Malcolm. Malcolm actually fears him. Tommy, he respects now, but didn't really fear, but who knows?
You see the other son on the show?
I don't know. They have to talk to me. There you go. Thank you. Yes, quick fire.
Now, I've got to say, I absolutely love your singing.
Thank you.
With that being said, with all the major motion picture musicals coming out, do you plan on doing any?
I don't have any plans. I need to be asked first, but I'd love to. I think it would be awesome. Yeah, so fingers crossed. Yes.
And your death scene, you know, you were very, like, composed. You didn't break down when you pushed the odds off the line.
Yep.
Was it your choice to stay, like, very composed?
It was my choice because I was pissed off that I was dying. Seriously. That was my choice. I wasn't going to show any emotion because I was really angry. In fact, they were like, the director came up to me and he said, this is a little secret, he said, I want you to really feel empathy and feel that I might just shoot the goddamn scene. Because I was gonna die. So I did. I wanted to be stoic and let the emotion come from Willa, who is, plays Thea. And so I thought that was more respectful in that way. But I wanted Malcolm, I was kind of pissed because Malcolm didn't get the death that he deserved. That's my opinion. Agreed. Yes, last one and then I'll sing.
Hi, John. My name's December.
Hi, December.
And two questions. My daughter won't ask. So if between you and Supergirl, who'd win?
Between John Barrowman and Supergirl?
Merlin.
I think it would be pretty close. Yeah.
Malcolm would
go into the shadows at the last minute. What else? No, I can't do that because people are paying for photographs and I can't really do that up here. Sorry, but thank you for asking. So what did I sing for you last time? Did I sing? No? Didn't I? Can I sing a really nice song?
Yeah.
About relationships? Is that okay?
Yeah.
Because has same-sex marriage passed in Illinois yet? It has. Awesome. This is a song that I did on my album to kind of emulate that all of the other states, other countries, we shouldn't have to be married. I'm married in three different places. It's bloody ridiculous. I should just have to be married once and celebrate it all over the world wherever I go. But also the story behind it, when gay marriage was passed, or marriage was passed for everybody, we went to the registrar's office in Palm Springs, and there was a lot of older people there, their 70s and 80s, and an older gentleman came to us after Scott and I witnessed all of it. He came up to us and he said, I really want to tell you that I'm overwhelmed, and we all know who you are, Mr. Barrowman, but I'm 84 years old, and I never thought in my lifetime I would ever be able to celebrate the love for my husband now and my partner, Tom, who's 78, because we have no family left. It's only us. And today, this is our family. And when I went home, I told Scott, I said, I'm going to record this song because nobody should tell you, however long you wait to find your true love, no one should tell you who or how you should love in your life. So, 1,000 years... Mr. Soundman, and if you can give me a lot up here in the cans and make it loud. Here we go. Mm-hmm.